Let's talk violin bowing technique. Did you know that there are over 100 different violin bowing techniques? This is what makes the violin one of the most versatile musical instruments. In this video, I'll explain each single one of them, how they are played on the violin, how they are notated in the sheet music, and I'll also give you for each one a beautiful example. If you're looking for something specific, then just use the timeline to skip to a certain bow stroke. Now let's dive right in. I have categorized the bow techniques in smooth, accented, and jumping bow techniques. Let's start with smooth. In smooth violin bowing techniques, the notes are played in their full length, sustained. Also, the bow is not jumping, and these are all active bowing techniques as opposed to passive bowing techniques like ricochet. We will talk about that in the jumping bow techniques. Simple détaché is the first bow stroke that you learn on the violin, and it's the default way of bowing. There are no special markings in the sheet music. The notes are played in their full length. You make seamless bow changes and you play one bow stroke per note. Accented détaché. By adding weight and bow speed in the beginning of the note, you get an accent. The notes are still played in their full length, they are connected, and you play one bow stroke per note. It's actually a combination of martelé and simple détaché. Accented détaché with a bite. This is a stronger version of the accented détaché without the bite. The note starts with a clear accent, and this is created with a little inflection of the index finger. Grand détaché are large, long, and fast bow strokes with a lot of energy and sound. The technique is similar to accent détaché, but it's a bit more solistic. Finger détaché is a bow technique done purely with the movements in the wrist and the fingers. It gives a very efficient and small détaché that's ideal for very fast passages. Détaché porté is a détaché with swelling in the beginning of the note, but it's not a click beginning like in martelé or accented détaché. Détaché lancé is a little bit similar to détaché porté, but it doesn't use the heavy swelling. Instead, it uses a bow speed that's more martelé-like. In détaché collé, the bow is lifted at the bow changes. It looks like a slow motion spiccato, and the movement in the bow hand fingers is very important for this. Tenuto means that the notes are played in their full length, but they're still clearly separated. This is opposed to staccato, in which you don't play the notes in their full length. This is more a musical articulation than a bow technique, actually, because it's simply détaché. Sans filet is a type of détaché with a very full and deep and rich sound. You create maximum resonance on your violin. Flautato or flautando is a bow technique with a whistling sound created by a high bow speed and very little weight in the bow. Often it's played on a very low contact point. Now don't confuse flautato with harmonics. That's a left-hand technique to create also a whistling sound. We'll get into harmonics later. Legato, you play multiple notes on one bow stroke and the transitions between the notes are very fluent. By changing the bow speed and the weight during a legato bow stroke, you create subtle separations between the notes. This gives a flowing yet rhythmical expression. When you have a lot of notes on one bow stroke, so a fast run, it helps for yourself and the listener to divide it in rhythmical units by very subtle accents. Portato is also a technique where you play several notes on one bow stroke, but you stop the bow for a very short moment in between the notes to separate them. In this way, you can also play several of the same notes on one bow stroke. Parlando is an alternative to portato. It looks the same in sheet music and you're free to choose. In portato we stopped the bow, but in parlando you keep the bow flow, but you give little inflections with your index finger to separate the notes. You can bow on two strings at the same time. And also put fingers on two strings at the same time. We call this double stops. On the violin, we can also bow on three strings at the same time. Sheet music, you have to play three or four notes at the same time. We usually play chords. Breaking a chord means that for a triple stop or a quadruple stop in the sheet music, you first play the two lower notes and then play the two higher notes. Now, feel free to prove me wrong, but with a normal setup of the violin, it's not really possible to play quadruple stops. Now, it is possible when you would flatten the bridge, might not want that, or use a special bow, like a rundbogen. Another way to play a chord on the violin is to arpeggiate them, so to just play them one by one. The gypsy bow stroke is a mixture between détachée and martelet. It's a way to play well-articulated fast notes with a gypsy feel. The notes are clearly separated and played with a bite. Harmonics are sounding overtones when you put your finger on the string, but don't push it down. This creates a whistling tone, and it's actually a left-hand technique, but it won't work if your bowing is not right. The bow stroke in harmonics must be heavy, of sufficient length, and relatively close to the bridge. Thank you. Let's go into accented violin bowing techniques. In general, these are on the string, they are active bowing techniques, and the notes are generally not played in their full length, so there is silence between the notes. Also, the notes can start with an accent done by the arm weight, the bow speed, or a pinch with the index finger. Martelé is French for hammered. The simple martelé starts with a bow speed or weight accent, but not the click that martelé is known for. After the initial impulse, you let the bow travel. Accented martelé is the martelé as you probably know it. So the note starts with a click. You create this click by catching the string with some weight in your bow. You see, maybe you don't see it, but I can move around the string like this. And in the beginning of the bow stroke, I release this, creating the click. And after that click, I let the bow travel. Collet is a technique where the fingers and wrist make a circular motion, resulting in an active off-the-string bow stroke with a firm sound. Martelé collet is an off-the-string martelé. It's lighter than the usual collet. It looks like a slow-motion spiccato, but it's actually a very active bow technique done close to the frog. Martelé porté, or sustained martelé, is when after the martelé beginning, the click, one doesn't just let the bow travel without weight, but one actually makes a normal bow stroke. You could also see it as a détaché with a martelé start. Martelé lancé is a somewhat longer martelé, or a somewhat shorter détaché. There is a higher bow speed at the beginning of each note to really separate the notes. The Viotti bow stroke is a practical application of a martelé, and we apply it if you first have a longer note on a weak beat that is slurred to a shorter note on a stronger beat. The Kreutzer bow stroke refers to two notes on one bow stroke, of which the second one has a martelé accent. So it's martelé within a slur. Simple staccatos are clearly separated notes that are not played in their full length. It's one of the first bow strokes that you learn on the violin. Solid staccato, and this one is also called a bow staccato, linked staccato or slurred staccato. It's in fact multiple staccato notes on one bow stroke, and you might make some inflections with your index finger to clearly articulate it. It's usually done on very fast runs and it can be very impressive. The bow does not leave the string. Staccato is where the bow does leave the string between the notes. You can see it as multiple spiccato notes on one bow stroke. Several staccato notes on a down bow require a bit more of a passive the bow technique that is closer to, for example, ricochet. So that's why I'm naming downbow staccato as a separate bow technique. Marcato simply means to mark the notes, and you can do that by separating the notes with a silence, or starting the note with an accent or a tag, or doing a decrescendo on each note. Usually marcato is not as firm as a martelé. Jeté lent is a quick upbow movement done at the frog. It starts on the string and it ends up in the air. It's not a bounce, but a fully controlled movement of the arm. Jeté vité is actually the same, but the notes start from the air instead of from the string, and this is usually applied when you have a sequence of two or more notes. Fouetté, or a whipped bow stroke, is creating an accent by lifting the bow and quickly whipping it back on the string. The slap stroke is done at the frog and it starts with a vertical slap down on the string. Let's go to jumping bowing techniques. In jumping bowing techniques, the bow jumps, leaves the string. So we use the natural bounce and energy that your bow has. The hand is more reactive, and these techniques are active, semi-passive, or passive. The notes are usually not played in their full length as the bow is in the air and the bow changes, creating some silence between the notes. Spaccato is a semi-passive bow technique. Your finger action gives the impulse and the bow bounces on its own. The simple brushed spaccato are large, heavy and slow bow stroke near the frog with a firm hand. This is an active bow technique. Brushed spaccato is a light on the string spaccato. It looks a little bit like détaché, but you do use the bounce of the bow and this gives some lightness to the sound. The bouncing ball bow stroke is a forceful and aggressive spaccato that is done by a vertical motion of the bow hand fingers. Lyric spaccato is a very elegant spaccato, mostly done with the side of the bow hair. The bounce is minimal. Crisp spaccato is a clearly articulated spaccato with a little bite. A dramatic spaccato is a large spaccato movement with a full sound, a low tempo and a relatively high bounce. The bow stroke is almost fully controlled by the hand, so it's a very active bow technique. String spaccato, or spaccato sulla corda, is a fast and firm spaccato. The bow does not leave the string, but the bow bounces in the spring system of the bow and the bow hair and the string. chopped spaccato is a very heavy and slow spaccato that we do when the tempo is too low or the dynamics should be too loud to do a real spaccato. Sautier is similar to spaccato, but it's at a higher speed and further up the bow. It's also a passive bow technique, so your fingers just give impulses and the bow bounces on its own. The frappé bowing technique is what you can use when sautier is indicated in the sheet music, but instead you use a very firm détaché with very short bow stroke. The result is that it sounds like sautier, but it can be a little bit louder and more clearly articulated. Flying spaccato are multiple spaccato notes on one bow stroke, but the bow stays in the same spot. So you make circular motions to ensure that you are playing up bows on that same spot of the bow. It looks a bit like flying staccato, but in flying staccato the bow actually travels and doesn't stay in one spot. After one impulse, the bow can bounce two times to around 20 times, and we call this ricochet. It's usually done on the down bow. A jumping arpeggio is actually ricochet over three or four strings, and you do it on the down bow as well as the up bow. Ricochet tremolo is usually done in a longer sequence of two up bows, two down bows, two up bows, two down bows. The tapping stroke is a light tapping motion to play several notes on one bow stroke. It's a bit lighter and more subtle than, let's say, a flying staccato. A standing spaccato is similar to the tapping bow stroke, but the bow stays in one place, so the bow doesn't travel. You make circular motions with your wrist and fingers. Let's talk orchestral bowing technique. Well, of course, all the bow techniques that we've discussed are also done in symphonic works. But there are some specific bow techniques that you'll use in an orchestra. Pizz stands for pizzicato, and that means to pluck the strings of the violin. And arco is back to bowing. There are actually 10 different plucking techniques on the violin. I'll explain them later in this video. Tremolo is playing very short détaché notes at the tip of the bow. Measured tremolo is when you play those tremolo notes in a specific rhythm. Collegno battuto means to bounce the stick of the bow, so not the hair, on the string. Collegno tratto means to make actual bow strokes with the stick of the bow. Be careful! Soltasto means to play close to or above the fingerboard. This creates a soft, muffled tone, or when you use it with a high bow speed, a more flute-like tone. Sul ponticello means to bow very close to the bridge. And as we can not really hear the tone itself, but the overtones, this creates this spooky sound. Punta d'arco means to play at the tip of the bow. This creates soft tone. Talon means to play at the frog of the bow, which creates a more firm tone. And I have no clue why we are used to say au talon in French and punta d'arco in Italian, but... Divisi bowing is when the bow direction is different within one section of an orchestra. This is done, for example, when an extended slur needs hidden bow changes. Staggered or free bowing is the effect of changing the bow randomly within one note to create the sound of a continuous note. So the members of a certain section in an orchestra do the bow change on different moments. Hooked bowing is not a bow technique as such, but a practice of connecting series of uneven note values in order to avoid unintended accents. So instead of you're doing, the classical motif also doesn't really refer to a specific bowing technique, but this is the practice that if you have a long note followed by two short notes and you have a series of that, that you play down, up, up instead of down, up, down. This is easier to do in a high tempo and the articulation is also cleaner and crispier. The softer motif is what we do when you have two notes of equal value, but you want to emphasize the first and the second one is a little bit shorter or softer. This sounds like a sigh. Padam, padam, instead of padam, padam. Smorzando or morendo is a big decrescendo into nothing. This is done by a very long bow stroke on a down bow, and that when you go to the tip, you take off more and more weight. Now I hope you'll stick around because I have over 20 basic violin bowing terms that I will explain. Also 10 different ways to pluck on the violin. But first let's go into some fiddle bowing techniques because we've been talking about a lot of classical music up until now. And also I have some very weird extended bowing techniques for you. Dragging the bow is a way to play quadruple stops. You unscrew the bow, wrap the hair around the violin, and then you can play on four strings at the same time. Shuffle. shuffles, like the Nashville Shuffle and the Georgia Shuffle, are bowing patterns in fiddle music. Shuffles are alternative ways to play the same tune or series of eighth notes. Chopping is making percussive sounds by letting the bow land on two strings at the same time, close to the frog. A drone is a specific type of double stop in fiddle bowing. Usually you play a melody on one string and you play that together with an open lower string. Modern music, we see some extended bowing techniques. The first one I'd like to show you is the bow screw glissando. You do this by holding the bow screw against the string, then you do a left hand pizzicato and you move the bow screw up and down the string. Now, and bowing on the strings all together is so old-fashioned. Why not bow on the soundbox, the bridge, the tailpiece, or the pegs? When you bow behind the bridge instead of here, then you get a very high squeaky sound. Ten violin plucking techniques. Besides from bowing, you can also make sound on the violin in the form of strumming, plucking or slapping the strings. Piz is short for pizzicato, and the standard way to do that is to hold the bow, to stick out your index finger, and to pluck the string. This is ideal when you have to switch between plucking pizzicato and arco bowing quickly. If you do pizzicato for a bit longer and you have time to switch, you can also just hold the bow in your fist and then securely place your thumb right here and then fits in that way. You can also do pizzicato with your left hand. So when you play a note with one finger, the other fingers are free to pluck the string. Sections or maybe entire movement or pieces that are pizzicato, you can just put away your bow and pizz. We can also play pizzicato chords. Pizzicato, sometimes done by moving the finger back and forth, is called pizzicato tremolo. In a snap or Bartok pizzicato, the string is pulled away so far that when you release it, it slaps against the fingerboard. Fingernail pizzicato is pizzicato with, you guessed it, the fingernail instead of the pad of your finger. Now, that's hard for a lot of violinists as we tend to keep our nails very short. quasi-guitar is to hold the violin like a guitar. And when you have your guitar holds, then you can of course also strum it like a ukulele or a guitar. Now let's go into over 20 basic violin bowing terms. Let's start with the bow hold. The bow hold is the way you hold the bow. This can be a Franco-Belgian bow hold or a Russian bow hold. Finger action are the movements your fingers make while bowing. Down bow is a bow stroke that goes from the frog to the tip. Up bow is from the tip to the frog. Choosing between the two is called a bow direction. Slurred bowing is playing multiple notes on one bow stroke. The bow change is the moment when the bow moves from down bow to up bow or the other way around. String crossing is when you move from one string to the other. Can be done on one bow stroke or separate. Bow division is the decision to play something lower on the bow or higher on the bow. Contact point is where the bow touches the string between the bridge and the fingerboard. Finger bowing is an exercise where you train the bow finger action by just bowing with your fingers. Bow tilts is when the bow stick is not straight above the hair, but you tilt it a little bit in the direction of the scroll. Then you play with the side of the hair. Inverse bowing is when you tilt the bow the other way around. Bowing straight means that the bow is in a 90 degree angle towards the string all the time. Slanted bowing means not bowing straight. You can do this, for example, to create a smooth bow change at the tip. Retaking your bow is what you do when you have a down bow and you want to play another down bow starting at the exact same spot of the bow. Landing the bow is putting back the bow on the string, for example, after a retake. Making an accent means to stress one note in relation to others. We have explicit accents, those are indicated in the sheet music, and we have implicit accents that are usually derived from the musical context and are generally more subtle. Dynamic accents are made by an increase in volume. You can play the note you want to stress louder, or you can give it a little click or bite with your index finger. Agogic accents are made by delaying the note a little bit or lengthening the note a little bit. In that way, the note is also stressed without making it louder. Bow attack sounds very exciting. Well, it's actually just how you start a note. You can start a note with a vowel-like beginning, a smooth attack, a départ attack, is a clearly articulated, more consonant-like attack. An accented attack means that the note starts with an accent. On the string attack means that the note starts on the string. Whipped attack means that the note starts off the string. Both on the string and whipped attacks can be done with or without an accent. Yay! Congratulations! You watched this video until the very end. And also thank you for watching all of this and nerding together with me around the bowing technique. I hope that this video has explained a lot, but it actually has mainly explained what. And to really go from where you are now on the violin and where you want to be on the violin, it's important that you actually learn to play these techniques yourself. Now, the secret is that there are 3 skills in bowing, and if you learn them and you learn the nuances you can make with them, you can quite quickly master all of these bowing techniques. And play the violin with feeling and tell the story you want to tell in your music. Now, I happen to have some open spots for new students in my online violin studio specialized in violin bowing technique. Now, if you like my teaching style, check out if it resonates with you at bowlikeapro.com. Now, thanks again for watching all of this. And now I need coffee.